Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Muhammad Rabil Kafi and my partner is Muhammad Arsi Fahrezi from 3ST2, and this is Information Architecture in Uber Eats Corporation. The definition of technology architecture, or as we know, IT architecture, is the design of information technology at the structural level. As information tends to be complex, it is often helpful to design it at both the structural level and implementation level. This is analogous to an architect designing a building and a variety of interior designers planning the interiors of the building's rooms. The objectives in technology architecture. There are two main objectives in technology architecture. First, develop the target technology architecture. There is a relationship between enabling logical application, physical application, company data and architectural vision. And the second one is the identify candidate architectural roadmap components based on the gap between the baseline and the target architecture technology. So the explanation of Uber Inc. Corporation is an American company that offers vehicle ride, food delivery, package delivery, and many more. Uber is also in a partnership with Lime to offer electric bike and scooter rental. Uber is one of the largest providers in the gig company. The history of Uber Inc. Corporation. First, Uber Cab was founded in 2009 by a computer programmer and co-founder of StumbleUpon, Gary Kemp and Travis Kalanick, whose software was Swoosh in 2007. The main goal of Uber is to find a way to reduce the cost of direct transportation and realize that that sharing the cost with the people could make it affordable. And this evolved into Uber. The beta of Uber Cab was launched in 2010, and the Uber Cab service and mobile application was launched in 2011 in San Francisco. Also in 2011, Uber Cab changed its name to Uber because getting complaints from taxi cab driver in San Francisco. This is our main topic, implementation of IT architecture in Uber Inc. Corporation. The platform, Uber's transportation mission is like a water, everywhere and for anyone. To make it possible, we create a complex of data. Then, the data get bundled up as neat as possible so the drivers and riders enable business get around. Here's the stack of Uber technology. Infrastructure and storage. Uber run a hybrid cloud model using cloud providers and multiply active data centers. Uber assigns city to the geographically closest to the data center. The provision of this infrastructure, Uber use a mix of internal tools and Terraform. For the storage, Uber currently use Scaemless, React, and Cassandra. Scaemless is for long data usage. React and Cassandra is for high availability, low latency demands. Uber also use Hadoop Warehouse for distributed storage and analytics for complex data. For caching and queuing, Uber use Redis. Uber also uses Twin Proxy to provide scalability of the caching layer without sacrificing cache hit rate with its consistent hashing algorithm. For logging, Uber uses multiple Kafka cluster and the data is archived into Hadoop. The data is also ingested in real time by various services and indexed into Elasticsearch, Logstash, and Kibana stack for searching and visualizations. Uber used Docker containers in Mesos to run microservices with consistent configuration scalable, with help from Aurora for running long service. Routing and service discovery. Uber used a combination of hyperproxy and hyperbound to communicate, to make the service able to communicate with each other in complex data. For the legacy services, use local hyperproxy to route JSON over HTTP request to other services, with front-end web server and GNX proxying to server in the back-end. Development and deploy. For this, Uber used Fabricator for code review to documentation to process automation. For the searching code, Uber used OpenGrok, and for tracking issue and code reviews, Uber used GitHub. For developing, Uber engineering used virtual machine running on cloud providers.
Okay, so my name is Muhammad Arsi Farizi from class 3 ST2, and now I'm going to continue about implementation of technology architecture in Uber. And I'm going to continue from the language of the backend server. So the Uber engineers primarily use Python, Node.js, Go, and Java. But primarily, the engineers in Uber use Node.js for the marketplace team, and for the rest of the team is using Python. And then for testing, Uber has two internal develop tools. The first one is Hailstorm and UDestroy. So Hailstorm is to drive the integrity test and also testing the peaks, simulate peak load and within the off-peak times. Meanwhile, UDestroy internationally for to break things so that the engineers can better on unexpected failures, can fix on the unexpected failures. And then visualization data. So visualization data is converting data into a visualization. So usually Uber use Storm and Spark to this, and also use JavaScript and React as the core tools. But usually Uber use standard web digital graphic tools such as Canvas 2D, SVL, and OpenWebGL. Next is mapping. For the mapping, Uber use Grafu to provide the teams for working in the data maps, and also to increase efficiency and accuracy by providing more sophisticated during routing option. And then now going to the middle stack, which in the marketplace stack. In the marketplace stack is the front end of the Uber engineering. Marketplace connect the request in the real time and relocation into engineering in Uber. In this stack also containing persistent layers, matching system, and then real-time request from the customer. In this stack also containing the logic of Uber Eats, and Uber Rush. The first thing on the marketplace stack is the route. The route of in Uber engineering in the marketplace stack containing of 600 stateless route. The route is created from the Node.js, but the edge of the route is created by Nginx front end does SSL termination with some authentication. The Nginx also provides some proxies to the frontline API to a proxy load balancer. For the throughput and speed is the key on the or the important part of the marketplace team because it connects the request on in real time. For the throughput and speed, the team use in cross functional tools Cassandra and Go. Next is data stream. Data stream is converting data into visualization. This team using JavaScript and React for the front end web development front end application. React plus Flux, D3 and Mapbox also used for the libraries and the framework behind this group. And for the data streaming, Uber use Kafka and Uber production database. Next, last thing is the top stack, which means the website and database, and the mobile apps. For the website, Uber create the website on top of Node.js, which many community in web engineering. Also, for the Node.js, Uber can share the JavaScript code between the client and the server to create a universal website. For the web server is built on top of Bedrock, which means built on top of the web Express.js, which has set of middleware and providing security. And then Uber specify APIs that handle infrastructure integration. Uber also use Atrio to communicate with the backend server which integrates with the Bedrock. For the rendering, state handling, and building, Uber use React.js, standard Flux. Uber also use a set of CSS React.js UI component built using Objects-Radium. For the previously, Uber use OOCSS / BGM style CSS toolkits. For the mobile, there are two types of mobile application for Uber, Android and iOS. For the iOS, is using Objective-C and Swift, and for the Android, is using Java. And the library, in the top stack, is using open source and third-party libraries built to fit specific needs. For the development, the Uber in this team Uber engineering in this team using Trunk development and Trunk release. Uber is still using GitHub for the uploading specific version of the mobile application, but all engineers working on the apps commit directly to the masters. And now for the mobile and the iOS, which means Android and iOS. For the Android first, Uber using Gradle as a build tool. Also, the team use OKHttp, Retrofit, and JSON for the networking, and Dagger for the injection of the framework. For the libraries, Uber used open source to keep the binary consist and easy. And also, the team use Butterknife to bind files and call back to the fields. And method via annotation processing, and then Picasso to provide image loading. Expresso extensions also used to enable to write a lot of native automation code using familiar Android SDK within the Android Studio Java IDE. The team also used RxJava to simplify the asynchronous and event-based programming. And then the Timber for logging. For the iOS team, or the iOS using monorepo, and the team using build with Bitbox. Masonry and Snapkit with auto layout help with component placement and sizing. For crash detection, the iOS team using KS Crash and the report crash during in-house internal reporting framework. For testing, is using Objective-C. The team use OCmock to mock up stub classes. And for testing, is using Swift. The team generates mocks via protocols. So that's all from us from Group 5. About technology architecture in the implementation in Uber. So, this is all from us. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.